I would like to welcome all of you to the Dixon High School virtual commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. I would like to thank Terry Fuger, Jim Grote, Jared Shaner, Doug Stansford, Dee Dee Sabu, Vanessa Ankney, Justin Monroe and his custodial staff, Margot Empin, Dan Rick, and the Dixon Board of Education, and all of our corporate sponsors for their effort in creating this virtual graduation ceremony. At this time, Emma Carlson, Senior Class President, will share her thoughts with you.
At the beginning of senior year, I imagined giving the speech to a field full of graduates and a crowd filled with family and friends. Instead, I'm addressing an empty gym, Dr. Grady, and a single recorder. Regardless, I still want to show all of you how much I will miss you and how much I know our class will do amazing things in the future. Welcome, Dixon High School graduating class of 2020. First, I'd like to thank some people for helping us get where we are today. I would like to thank Dr. Grady, the amazing office ladies, the janitors, the counselors, the teachers, and all other staff that I have not mentioned. Also, I would like to thank my parents and the parents of the class of 2020. Thank you for helping us get where we are today. And most importantly, I would like to thank my classmates. Some of you I've been with since Ms. Palmer's third grade class. The class where collectively we broke about 15 bones together because of a cursed tiki that Ms. Tiki had in her classroom. And some of you I've gotten to know this year, and I'm so happy that I did. You guys made high school amazing and have helped me create memories that I will never forget. I remember the first day of freshman year when half of us couldn't figure out how to correctly walk up the stairs and the other half didn't know where our classes were, but we wouldn't ask the upperclassmen because we were terrified of them. We attended homecoming where most of us uncomfortably danced in the back. We said YOLO and hashtag like they had just suddenly become part of our vocabulary, and we had gotten used to the parts of the ceiling falling on us. I'm not gonna lie, we've had it pretty tough. As Charles Dickens wrote, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times. We have survived AP exams and the SAT as juniors. We went through a phase where clowns were running all over town and everyone was freaking out. We have gotten through numerous Friday night football games where we had to inhale the purple smoke that smelled horrible, but I'll admit, it looked pretty cool. We've gotten through that time last year where the high school felt like Antarctica and we were told to bring coats to class. We have survived a school shooting together thanks to Officer Dallas and Coach McKay. We've gotten through many early mornings where Dr. Grady would scream at us from outside the cafeteria just to tell us how good of a day it was going to be. We have survived the fire our freshman year that we all thought was a senior prank. And currently we're getting through coronavirus together. And despite all the odds, we still managed to graduate. We've been challenged as individuals and as a class, and through those challenges, our class has accomplished so much these past 4 years. This year, our girls basketball team won conference and went to the regional championship. Our boys cross country team got second at state. Our girls cross country team got second at conference. Our pep band put on fantastic performances at all the home basketball games. Sebastian Quintana qualified for the state wrestling meet and placed third. The cast and crew of the fall play brought us an awesome production. And our football team made it to the playoffs where many of us cheered them on from the student section. Even though we are missing out on track, girls soccer, golf, baseball, softball, boys tennis, group interpretation, and the spring musical, I know our class would have had an amazing last few months at Dixon High School. These great accomplishments came from hard work and have brought us together as a class. These memories have only made us stronger as people. As we leave Dixon High School and start a new chapter in our lives, it's not going to be the grades, popularity, or social media that you remember. It's going to be the memories that you've made and the people that you've crossed paths with. It's going to be the relationships you've had and the type of person you were. That's your legacy that you have left at Dixon High School. After today, we will no longer be students at Dixon High School, but active members of society. We will be writing our own stories filled with life's ups and downs. Some of you are going to join the military, where you will make us all proud and serve our country. Some of us will become doctors and scientists, where we might cure disease. Some of us will study theater and bring happiness to audiences. Some of us will become educators and teach future generations. And maybe some of us will be politicians and make great changes to our country. Regardless of what you become and where you end up, I know you will do amazing things in the future. I want you all to remember that to achieve greatness is not about the money or the awards, but to imprint on the lives of others and to give them a little more hope and happiness than they had before. In the future, when you have families and jobs, I want you to remember this year, 2020, and remember how challenging it was, but I also want you to remember how we overcame the challenges and came out even stronger than we were before. 2020 is our year. It's been an amazing past 4 years with you all, and from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very, very best. Thank you.
For the past 14 years, we have been honoring our students who intend to enter the military, and I'm sure that we do not do these students justice and their families. But I would like to personally thank them for their sacrifice so that we may live free. The following Dixon High School seniors will be joining the military after graduation: Nicolette Fizikas, Kayla Callison, Jordan Olalde, Thomas Sitter, Samantha Andreas, Zachary Bass, Cade Frey, Patrick Grossman, Gable Hale, Erica Miller, Sarah Miller, Nicole Stocksdale, Noah Williams, Sydney Reagan, Claretta Kern Lyons, and Austin Schultz. Thank you. At this time, we recognize our Senior Superior Honor graduates. In order to earn this award, seniors must have achieved a grade point average of 3.81 or higher for the 4 years they've been in high school. They will receive a gold tassel. They are Madison Rubright, Josie Shaner, Brooklyn Dobman, Christian Segrin, Garrett Helfrick, Cade Fulton, Isaac Hernandez, Nicolette Fizikas, Courtney Marsh, Evelyn Ebersol, Melody Breckenfelder, Braden Sheline, Austin Portner, Peyton Fitzsimmons, Madeline Gussie, Sophie Doan, Rachel Rumpf, Logan Griswold, Molly Biggs, Taylor Rankus, Emma Carlson, Aiden Johnson, Charlotte McCoy, Noah Grote, Nicholas Engel, Jasmine Connolly, Emma Johnson, Grace Wadsworth, Eden Varr, Cameron Crone, Ethan Sherman, and Riley Cavanaugh.
Ms. Chamberlain here saying congratulations, class of 2020. I want to give you one more fist pump before you go.
Congratulations to the DHS class of 2020.
Hey, class of 2020, it's Mr. Olson. Congratulations and good luck.
Congratulations, Dixon High School class of 2020. Keep on trucking.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Mrs. Durrell here. I would like to give you my best wishes in your future endeavors, and I hope you all are safe and healthy.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You're the GOAT.
Hey, class of 2020. Congratulations on all your accomplishments and hard work. Appreciate everything you did for DHS. Make sure you get some sunglasses because your future is bright. Congratulations.
Class of 2020, I've had a number of different metaphors that I was going to use in my original speech, linking 2020 perfect vision with a clear outlook for your future. But recent events have created a future that is anything but clear. If you're watching this video with thoughts of feeling cheated, frustrated, and anger, I completely understand. All of you are entitled to these feelings. With the passing of time, I hope you allow yourself to reflect on your current accomplishments. If you do, I believe that you will see a bright future. What this pandemic has reaffirmed for me is that we are put on this earth for a finite amount of time. We have a choice to flounder in frustration and disappointment or flourish in opportunity and possibilities. To further my point, I would like to share with you two quotes. The first is from Elizabeth Kubler-Ross. The most beautiful people I've known are those who have known trials and have struggles and have known loss and have found their way out of the depths. The second is from Sonia Sotomayor. There are uses for adversity, and they don't reveal themselves until tested. Whether it's serious illness, financial hardship, or simple constraint of parents who don't speak English, difficulty can tap unexpected strengths. Class of 2020, you are some of the strongest students I know. Do not let this pandemic define you. Let it be the catalyst for all your future success. Best wishes, class of 2020.
Hey, class of 2020, this is Mrs. Hansen. Congratulations, and go out there and live your best life.
Congratulations, DHS class of 2020. Good luck in your future.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You've made it. Best of luck in your future endeavors, wherever that may be, whether it's college, military, employment, trade school. Wish you nothing but success. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020, and good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Very proud of you.
We'll miss you.
The office ladies.
Hey, class of 2020. It's been great to be with you the last 4 years. It's been a privilege to be an assistant principal here at Dixon High School. I'm really looking forward to see what you guys have in your future. Thanks, and I hope you have a great summer.
This year's salutatorian is Ethan Sherman. Ethan is the son of Paula and Warren Sherman. During his 4 years at Dixon High School, Ethan was a member of the Student Council, Key Club, National Honor Society, Blind, Freshman Mentoring, and was captain of the golf team. Next year, he will attend Marquette University in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, majoring in business. Ladies and gentlemen, Ethan Sherman.
Today, we are here to celebrate the culmination of the class of 2020's academic successes as we prepare to depart onto the next chapter of our lives and the great unknown that is to follow. I cannot emphasize how proud I am to be able to graduate alongside so many other driven, intelligent, and well-rounded individuals who have greatly shaped me into the person I am today throughout these past 4 years. I would like to welcome and thank all the parents and family members here today on behalf of their commitment to ensuring the academic success of their class of 2020. The success of any student in school and later as an adult starts with the example those at home set for them through their actions and support of their children in each chapter of their life. Similarly, the role of the bonds created between teachers and students throughout their years of education plays a major role in the development of any student into a capable adult. The care shown through the willingness of the staff here to ensure every student's success is commendable and goes beyond what I could have ever expected it would. Mr. Eastman, as my golf coach, you were my first true introduction to high school as a whole, and I cannot think of anyone else who I would have rather had in that place. You somehow transformed me from a scared freshman who lacked the coordination to swing a golf club and would have rather been anywhere else in the world than at golf practice into a person who isn't afraid to try new things, even if these new things result in failure. Your leadership, lighthearted demeanor, and sense of humor will never be forgotten by me. Mrs. Beck, your ability to make every day in your class unique through random yoga sessions when you felt our chakras need to be realigned, or a thumb wrestling tournament between Kate and I that lasted the entirety of the hour, taught me to simply be myself. These random moments and your emphasis on speeches and presentations in your class taught me to use one of the most important tools in life, my voice. From this class, I learned to not be afraid of voicing my opinions and how to just take everything a little less seriously. And I doubt any of us will be able to look back in our years in high school without thinking about Dr. Grady and his commitment and overpowering optimism towards our education. His wardrobe of costumes and characters brightened the dullest of days, and his many tangents on the amazing world of math were always sure to elicit a smile. I could easily speak for upwards of an hour strictly on how the teachers and staff have created an impact on me and taught me important lasting lessons I will take with me as I further my education and become a part of the real world. The care that they put into teaching truly shows not only their raw passion towards their jobs, but their genuine care towards the academic success of each of their students, which is something none of us should undervalue in the slightest. As we move into the next chapter of our lives, equipped with the valuable lessons and wisdom imparted upon us by our families and teachers, we must not forget one of the most important and humbling experiences that we can cross our paths, failure. The sad reality of life is that it rarely conforms to the blueprint we build in our dreams. Look how this year ended. None of us could have predicted that senior sports seasons would be stripped away, clubs ended, and memories never to be made. The odds are that most of us will not be able to make our dreams become reality, that we'll have to settle for less than what we feel we deserve in life, and our dreams only exist as reminders of the hopes of a younger self. But the important part of these letdowns and these moments of humility is how we move forward. Our dreams are what motivate us through each chapter of our lives, while our failures allow us to mature into individuals capable of making these dreams into reality. We didn't just throw in the towel because we weren't happy with the hand that was dealt to us this year. We're all here today because we pushed through these hardships. I am more than confident in this class's ability to do so throughout the rest of your lives. To the entirety of the class of 2020, thank you for making these past 4 years memorable and making me the person I am today. I wish you all the best of luck and truly hope that each of you find success and happiness. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to present to you the valedictorian of the class of 2020, Riley Cavanaugh. Riley is the daughter of Susan and Tim Cavanaugh. During her 4 years at Dixon High School, Riley was involved in Key Club, Student Council, National Honor Society, and bowling. Next year, she will attend the University of Wisconsin-Platteville, majoring in elementary education. Ladies and gentlemen, Riley Cavanaugh.
Welcome to the graduation of the class of 2020. I would like to begin by saying thank you to the teachers and staff at Dixon High School, the parents, families, friends, and of course, the students who have all made today possible for the class of 2020. It is my honor to address you all today as we prepare to begin our separate journeys on different paths in our lives and work toward our future goals. I remember entering Dixon High School on my first day as a freshman and feeling excited, curious, and most of all anxious about the next 4 years of my life. As the shy introvert that I was when beginning high school, and that I still quite honestly am today, I held a lot of fear about my new environment and wondered how I would be able to achieve success and feel comfortable in such a daunting place as it seemed at the time. If I am being honest, I continued to struggle with my fears throughout the years. Many times in the classroom, feelings of nervousness overwhelmed me as I prepared to present or give a speech or even just share an answer or my thoughts with the class. Feeling uncomfortable in the classroom was a challenge that I faced many days because of my fears. But through my struggles, I pushed myself to stay focused and achieve success and continued to persevere and work through my fears. Even though I could not truly get rid of the anxiety that I often felt, I adapted and learned how to manage it and still reach my goals. I did not want to let this obstacle hinder my success. In the words of motivational speaker and author Brian Tracy, the key to success is to focus our conscious mind on things we desire, not things we fear. When I struggled in the classroom, I learned to set my mind on my goals and realized that to reach them, I would ultimately have to get through the fears that I faced, which I knew would be worth it in the end. Our challenges and moments of fear are only temporary in the grand scheme of life, but the success and achievements that result from facing and pushing through them will stick with us, and we will remember how we worked hard to get what we desired. On everyone's path to their own successes, worries and obstacles exist. But by recognizing challenges and working through them instead of being defeated by them, an individual can accomplish the goals they set their mind to. Once I knew how to tolerate the fear that often came along with my experiences at school, I was able to feel content and could thrive. This mindset, along with the support of my friends, teachers, and most importantly, my family, got me through these last 4 years. I want to say thank you to everyone who encouraged me and helped make my time at Dixon High School so great. Going forward, I will look back at my time at this school with happiness and gratitude because my experiences here in these 4 years have shaped who I am and who we all are today and will grow to be in the future. Of course, after graduation, I'll miss the typical high school experiences like homecoming week and football games, but it's the unique components about Dixon High School separating it from other schools that I know I will likely miss the most. The occasional appearances from Corncob Carl or walking up to the fourth floor every day after lunch this year, and even the noises of construction throughout the years are all aspects that I will remember when I think about my time at Dixon High School, because these experiences are what made my time here different, and I appreciate that. I want to give a shout out to the senior spring athletes who did not get to compete in their final season of their sport, and senior members of theater, choir, and band who did not get to participate in their final performances. Our senior year did not end like any of us could have imagined it, but we are all in it together, and I know that I could never forget this time in my life. Once again, I want to thank the teachers and all the staff here for all they have done for us and will continue to do for students in years to come. With that being said, I would like to end by saying farewell to the Dixon High School Class of 2020 and congratulations. Thank you.
Our final speaker is Mrs. Linda Wegner, President of the Board of Education.
Hello, I'm Linda Wegner, President of the Dixon School Board. From the Dixon School Board of Education, we wish you our heartfelt congratulations. Now, I know this is not the graduation you envision, and I can only imagine all the feelings you have right now, from anger and disappointment to sadness and grief. I know you won't want to hear that life is full of mixed feelings like this, because this is like no other moment in time. This was supposed to be your special moment, and you feel cheated. I will tell you that the effort and achievement it took to get here is still great, no matter what. That if we could fix this for you, we would. We are proud of you. Your own principal, Dr. Grady, wanted to hand deliver your diplomas to each and every one of you. That shows you how much he cares, and we do too. The situation we are in will not take away all the memories you've made the last 4 years, nor will it steal from you the wonderful futures you have ahead. For you're young, and you have many years left. You will forever have a bond with all other graduating seniors of the class of 2020 and many other people who wanted to celebrate other milestones this year. And finally, when I was asked to speak to you today, I was reminded of advice that Mr. Rogers gave in times of tragedy. You know, he told preschoolers to look for the helpers. He knew that would make them feel safer and better. I know you're adults now, so I have to change that up a bit, but I do ask you, as you go out into the world, see in what ways you can be the helpers. That might make you feel better too. Thank you from all of us and congratulations.
Class of 2020, I want you to know that your community supports you. A number of community members wanted to send you a brief supporting message of you. So please enjoy. Thank you.
Dr. Grady asked us to do a video for the high schoolers that are graduating. I've been running around trying to find an officer that's able to do it. Unfortunately, they're all busy. So, let's go to Harry. He's agreed to do it. You have to bear with him though. He's European, so his accent's a little hard to understand.
Guten Tag, Dixon High School Class of 2020. This is K9 Harry. Congratulations on graduating after years of hard work. Wunderbar! The Dixon Police Department wishes you success in the coming years. Why do I sound like this? Because I am a German Shepherd.
Congratulations, Dixon High School Class of 2020.
Congratulations, DHS Class of 2020.
Hi, I'm Dwayne from the Dixon Park District. Like many of you, my journey started here. And that journey continued here.
Some people think the journey ends here with graduation day, but there is still much more to achieve for you guys. Congrats to Class of 2020 from the Dixon Park District.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. I'm Ben Boss. As a fellow alumni, wish you all the brightest futures.
From the Dixon City Firefighters to the Dixon graduating high school class of 2020, we want to say congratulations and good luck in your future endeavors.
Congratulations!
Hi, I'm Chief Arand. On behalf of the Dixon Rural Fire Department and the Dixon Rural Firefighters Association, I would like to say congratulations to the Dixon High School Class of 2020. I know this chapter in your life might not have ended the way you thought, but move on to the next chapter, have fun, and stay safe.
The First National Bank in Amboy wishes the Class of 2020 success and happiness in your future endeavors. Congratulations!
Shout out to all the graduates. Don't let the weather or COVID-19 dampen your spirits. Congratulations.
Hello everybody, it's Isaiah Roby here. I hope you guys had a great 4 years at Dixon High School. And I just wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020.
2020 graduates, good luck in all your future endeavors.
Congratulations, Dixon High School graduating class of 2020. We're so proud of you, and you are now our new alumni. Remember, hashtag go purple.
Congratulations, Dixon High School class of 2020.
Hey, Mrs. Ramirez here. Just wanted to say congratulations to the Dixon class of 2020. Go out and continue to make us proud.
Bailey Lynn Underhill. Stegbaum.
Graduates, you made it. We're proud of you. Go get them.
Congratulations, Dixon High School Class of 2020.
Seniors, it's been such a joy watching you grow from little sixth graders to young adults. Go out and live your best life.
Good luck, class of 2020. The future is yours.
Jacob Matthew Schaefer. Serena Nicole Dodge. Thank you.
Alexis Lee Snead. Charlotte Lee McCoy.
Congratulations, Dixon High School, Class of 2020. Best wishes to all of you.
Congratulations, DHS 2020. Shout out to the cross-country runners. You got this.
Hello, Class of 2020. Congratulations on graduating from high school. I wish you all the best of luck. And also, remember, there's only three things you can do with money. You can spend it, save it, and of course, invest it. Good luck.
Mary O'Donnell. Amy Michael Jackson. Noah Dwayne Keel.
Wadsworth.
Hey Dukes and Duchesses, class of 2020, congratulations and best of luck in the future.
Congrats, class of 2020. Best wishes for the future.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. May you reach for the stars.
Congratulations, Dixon High School, class of 2020. Go Dukes!
Congratulations, class of 2020. We are very proud of you.
Felicidades, seniors. Estoy muy orgullosa de todos.
Hey, class of 2020. Coach Burgess here. Just want to give you a shout out and say congratulations on your graduation. I hope for the best for all of you. It's been a pleasure having all of you in class. And again, congratulations on your graduation, class of 2020.
16.
Cheyenne Faith Presley.
Thank you.
Trevor Dean White. Mia Catherine Bailey.
Congrats, class of 2020. Go out there and rock this world.
Congratulations, Dixon High School class of 2020.
Hi, kids. It's Mrs. Corkin. Congratulations, class of 2020. It's been my pleasure getting to know many of you during your 4 years at DHS. I wish you joy. I wish you love. I wish you peace. God bless.
Congratulations, seniors, especially those in the 2007-2008 kindergarten class, Mrs. Alston.
Michael Amos Keeley. Ayesa Louie Schumann. Marsh.
Nicolette Delian Kazikas. Christian Charles Seeger.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Good luck ahead.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. We're all so very proud of you. We know it's been hard, but you've persevered and you're going to go on to do great things. Congratulations and best of luck.
Hey, Dixon class of 2020. Officer Dallas here. I want to tell you congratulations and remember, Duke Pride.
Class of 2020, there's only two things I have to say to you.
Congratulations! And good luck!
Gable Thomas Jeffrey Hale.
Jacob William Wickert. Isaac Alonso Hernandez. Caleb Daniel Crawford. Chloe Alexandria Shaw. Isabella Christine Reyes. Cody Allen.